Welcome to this FEI Beat the Heat episode about competition management and emergency response for humans performing in hot and humid environments. In this video, we will show you how you can optimize your performance while competing, as well as identify signs of heat distress in yourself and others, and how to respond efficiently. These tips for maximizing your performance and safety are geared mainly towards athletes in training, but they apply equally to officials, volunteers, and staff members working in hot and humid climates. Let's start with a quick reminder. During the first days after arrival, you should focus on rest and recovery before starting any training in the heat. Once you do start training, remember to increase heat exposure and training intensity progressively in order to ensure a smooth acclimatization process and optimal work conditions. Competition management. First, apply the pre- and post-competition cooling strategies you have fine-tuned during your preparation phase at home. This means, before exercise, stay cool as long as possible, and after exercise, cool down as soon as possible. Minimize unnecessary heat and sun exposure and protect yourself at all times using UV sunglasses, a hat or a cap, the wider the brim, the better, sunscreen, adapted and light-colored clothing, ice vest, and always make sure you stay hydrated. Drink regularly and throughout the day. If necessary, complement with an isotonic drink after competition or intense exercise. As a para-athlete, you may have to follow additional measures specific to your condition and prescribed by your sports physician. Finally, dedicated heat management rules and policies may already be in place at an event. Make sure you have read them, understood them, and that you stay fully up to date. Congratulations! You have now done everything to handle heat and humidity in the best possible way. But do you also know how to identify signs of heat illness? Would you be able to respond in an emergency, knowing what to do could save your life or even someone else's? Let's start by identifying the different signs and symptoms. Feeling suddenly tired, weak, faint, or experiencing dizziness, headaches or muscle cramps, nausea and vomiting, heavy sweating, intense thirst, fast pulse, erratic behavior or speech, loss of consciousness and convulsions. If you or anyone around you is experiencing these symptoms, it might well be heat distress or even heat stroke, and you will need to react immediately. If it happens to you, stay calm, call for help, and request medical assistance. If you see these signs on someone else, call for medical assistance and start this first help procedure. Bring the person to a cool area or in the shade if possible. Lay the person down and elevate their feet. Loosen their clothing and/or remove any unnecessary layers. Try to cool the person immediately with what's available to you: fan, ice vest, cold patches. Give water or isotonic fluids. Keep talking to the person and wait for help. If you have suffered any heat-related illness, even a mild one, consult your doctor and adapt protection, cooling, and hydration strategies accordingly. It might take up to 4 weeks to recover, so stay vigilant at all times and follow the recommendations. For more information about all things related to heat and humidity, check our other Beat the Heat videos so that you are fully prepared to compete in hot and humid environments. Bye for now, and go beat that heat!